Let's do this!
Hello there, guys. WikiDoo here to give you another class to show off in the new Let's Play Team Fortress 2. In this one, we're going to introduce you to the Speed Demon, who also has a pretty potent shotgun to use. This here is the Scout. So, when I do say Speed Demon, I do mean a Speed Demon. So, he's pretty much the fastest class out of all the classes. Well, normally. There might be some other exceptions, but most of the time you are the fastest class. So due to his speed, and also with his double jump mechanic, he's able to go ahead and basically be a harasser, flanker, and a very good, like, class for objective-based stuff, because he's also capable of capping points twice as fast. So right now, using the scatter gun, which is a souped-up shotgun, basically, to go around to the sides, go ahead and pick them off, just like that. And I'll go ahead and cap the point here with double the speed. And I'm constantly moving around, so that'll give the sniper a hard time to get me. Gonna give that sniper some guessing work trying to get to me. And just like that. So yeah, of all the primaries that the Scout is going to have here, Scattergun is pretty much going to be your most reliable one. Does a lot of souped up damage. If you happen to get someone up close, the word for it is called a meat shot. Basically, if you get like around like 100 damage, it's a meat shot. Woo! Just like that. That was pretty heated, actually. And also to help finish him off, there's also the pistol, another good sidearm to have. Good for like, even up close to medium distance. Yeah, nice, just like that. So yeah, really the scout is really all nice souped up for defense, or not defense, offense. My god, again, the terminology's wrong. But yeah, he's very good for offense, very good for a lot of 1v1 situations due to having a hard time for the enemy trying to land a hit on you. Oh, he got confused. Except he has a medic on him. Oh. There we go. Saved him. You'll live for another day there, sniper. And you also have a... Whoopsie. I'm getting the hell out of dodge. And also with the standard melee, which is a bat. Now, compared to other standard melee stuff, this one swings a lot faster, but it has low damage. So, the whole concept of the bat is just there, you know, to... he's probably gonna chase after. Because we got, like, nothing back here.
Alert. The control point is being contested.
Nice. Here, I'm gonna go ahead and give chase. No, didn't cut my corners well. There, good stuff. So anyway, swings fast, low damage and all that stuff. This here melee is just meant for like, if you're like out of like, nothing in your clip or something like that. Take a bit of time for you to like reload and shit. Jeez, took him long enough. Here, I'm gonna make him pop it. There you go. Yeah, I'm guessing that medic saw me and he had to pop it. I don't know what hit me. Oh shit, he got the health. He's gonna get me. Wow, I lived. I'm surprised, actually. I'll snag that. Here, I'm gonna go with the upper path. See what I can do to... What? What? Okay, I don't know what happened there, and... What happened to our defense? It felt like that as soon as I died, they just moved in and like, you know... This day is not yours, basically. Yeah, much like in a lot of cases, a standard loadout with your default is going to be your most effective, pretty much. So as always, a good harasser, good flanker, and all that stuff. I'm not sure what else to say about it. Oh yeah, gotta keep in mind that you do have a low health pool, so... Since you do have the speed, the downside is that you have low health. So you are a light class after all. Glass cannon, basically. He's scoped in. You can pick him off. That was an evil crit.
You got holes.
Now let me cap this now. Well, let me grab this first. Alright, seeing how well we're gonna do, I'll go ahead and see about switching out weapon loadouts here, because I don't have anything else to say, but yeah, since you are a low health class, be mindful of some classes that do have certain things that could somehow negate your movement speed and such. Such as anything that slows you down, causes you knockback, or anything that tracks you down, a la sentry gun, that basically spells instant death, so... But in most cases, if anything tries to negate your speed, you can try getting it back up by using your double jump to regain composure. And yes, since you do have double jump, you'll be able to get into a lot of places that other classes can't get to. Well, except for like, you know, like some classes like... Sticky trapped. Yeah, it's sticky trapped. There's nothing I can do about it. Unless I try to shoot the stickies, but, you know, there's too much clutter as it is. There we go. I'm sorry, what? Much better! Haha! Victory conga for everyone! Alright, that's enough of that. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of the weapon loadouts here now. Alright, so let's talk about some... There's one for the primary. Force in Nature. Now, for whatever reason, even for myself at the time, Force of Nature is considered to be like, everyone seems to like to hate this for some odd reason, but I can understand why. Because first off, you only have two shots in this, so you want to go ahead and make your shots count. And what it does is that it causes knockback upon shot. And also has a slow reload. So I really don't know what to make of this. It's just there's some sort of like utility sort of a deal. Pretty much what you try to do is you need to hit them once, pop into the air, and just shoot them again. And it also shoots slightly faster, like bam, bam. Although you don't want to do that. You want to go ahead and time your shots just right. Yeah, I probably shouldn't shop there. I alerted his presence. Of my presence. Now, let me go ahead and swing around this way. And for whatever reason, they're not capping. Except for this guy. Whoops. Okay. Wasn't able to get the other shot, but I always have the pistol for backup. Oh, God! Damn. Should have gone after the medic first. I should have prioritized that. So yeah, it does heavy first damage but long reload. So I consider that to be like a hit and run weapon. And knockback can mess with the other player's aim, so to speak. And actually, you can do self knockback on yourself as well. So, gotta make sure that if you do a shot in the air, it's gonna pop you backwards. And because of the self-knockback, you can actually go ahead and try to, like, do some weird jumps with this. In fact, I have to try to teach you right now on how to do it. What you do is that you need to try to aim at a specific angle. Some, kind of like this angle right here. And then you just, like, jump and then shoot at the same time. You'll pretty much get up that high. Oh, I didn't equip the taunts for that loadout. My bad. But when you try to mess with this for the first time, it's going to be pretty daunting to try it out, because the overall feel of this weapon can be kind of difficult to aim. And maybe it's because of, like, you know, the weapon being in front of your face could be it, or the general sound of it. I don't know. It's just... And also the long reload. And for some reason, I hated this back in the day, but considering what there is right now, there is some utility to it, I suppose. But in terms of, like, damage output, scattergun still seems to be the better choice. Well, I guess there's the downside of that, is I knocked him into my teammates. And I guess they don't like me for doing that. Okay, but, alright, so force of nature, I don't know. It's alright. So anyway, the other one I have is the Pretty Boy's Pocket Pistol. This allows me to have 15 more health, although it doesn't show that right now. If I didn't have that other weapon equipped right here, it would be like 140. So, 15 more health. There's no fall damage. Although the one downside is that, I'm getting out of there. However, the downside is that you're more vulnerable to fire, so once you're in within range of the pyro, well, holy shit, you're gonna die faster than... Insert clever thing here. although it shoots a bit slower, but still standard damage, I think. If I can take a quick peek at the stats. Yeah, pretty much that. Also, what I have in my loadout, if I forgot to show... That's the Sandman. This here is a right-click ability to toss a baseball at some player's head. And depending on the distance, will stun them for a certain amount of time. So the further away, the longer it'll last. So it'll stun them, making them unable to, like, you know, attack back. Although they can still move around, but just a little bit. However, if you get them at the maximum range with the baseball, it'll flat out, like, make them immobile. And we'll help cap this. Now, I don't remember the numbers for how long the stun will last at max distance, but, you know, if you're kind of the guy that don't really likes to go into melee all the time, which I guess, like, in terms of damage output, you probably shouldn't, this can be good for utility, although it takes minus 15 health. That's the downside. So you're definitely more vulnerable. Oh, hey, dispenser. Well, if I didn't want to waste my ammo, that's what I have the melee for. Right, let me check the situation up here. Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah, sentries. I won't be able to do anything unless my team does something. So I'm just going to have just go ahead and search around for, like, stragglers. Whoops. Failed to do the other shot. Our control point is being captured. Point, you moron. There's, like, a couple of other stats on the force of nature I forgot about, like some extra bullets, some sort of damage penalty, and something like that. Yeah. Okay, spy, are you wanting to go in and do stuff? Oh, hi. I see your team just appeared out of nowhere. Nope, didn't recharge yet.
Time has been added.
Wait, did I hear a sentry around here? Our stuff? It's our stuff.
Fire. Thanks, Pally.
Ah, thank you. Because, you know, I was on fire. I would have died sooner. No, oh, what the hell? Where did you charge from? B- But yeah, like I was saying, like, if you don't normally melee stuff, the Sandman can be good for utility if you can effectively, like, stun them in the face with that. Hi. Well, that was something. Let's try another one. Yeah, sure, why not? Let me try to reapply it. There we go. Alright, so let me go ahead and show you the full set here. If you remember a while ago, there used to have been a thing with the Poly Count Pack update. Next level to Fastlane, but we're on Fastlane. Okay, but anyway, if you remember back in the day with the Poly Count update, there was this thing where classes get a set of weapons, and when you have a complete set, that if you have a complete set, it'll apply like a special like set bonus to you. However, considering that the players have to go through the effort of getting said weapons to get the set bonus, it's considered to be like kind of like unfair like advantage, so to speak. So eventually, later down the line, certain class sets just got reduced to like either like none or leaving a calling card. So that's the case with this whole Milkman set that I have for the Scout. This is like the only set that I have with the Polycount stuff that I've ever completed, even before the change to the whole set bonus thing. So that's a little bit of history with that. So yeah, with this here, I just leave a calling card, so upon killing someone... Well, I kind of showed that a little bit earlier when I killed the spy, but you kind of didn't see it.
Fire, fire, fire.
Yeah, they're probably not going to put me out, so I'm just going to nab this. Okay. You know, there's like enemies up there that's gonna be popping out anytime. Oh, here, let me try to assist the pyro. So I can get him with this. Well, no more forward spawns, I suppose. There we go. Got him unprepared. That's all well and good. Anyway, let's talk about weapons here. So I got the shortstop here. So this is a very odd weapon because it tried to like had some sort of like effect to it when it initially came out. Something about like every time that you unhit, the enemy gets slowed down by a certain amount of seconds, like half a second. But for some odd reason, it wasn't working. So they pretty much scrapped the idea and just considered it like some sort of like weird scattergun pistol hybrid. And I just got my medic killed because he was following me. And this weapon can be very, very finicky in terms of like trying to like effectively aim them, because the scene like the weapon spread is very questionable. Oh well, here's the calling card. Nice. You're a spy. Looks like Demo heard that too. Nope. So yeah, it kind of like went through a little bit of history and stuff like that. It used to reload like really fast, the same speed as like the pistol, but now they slowed it down and all that such. And how the damage works is kind of like very well for like medium range sort of approach. And he immediately took the health back, and that was a backscatter thing, because my back was shown, but I killed him anyway. Okay. But ultimately the shortstop became it so that now, you know, after the whole polycount thing, it basically took kind of like some of the concepts of the set bonuses and migrated them on over to the weapons. In this case, for the shortstop, they made it so that you get increased healing from all sources, so... Like, faster healing rate, I think you might get like a health bonus from packs or stuff like that, like... Well, I wouldn't know, but... You get better healing out of this. However, the downside, and it's kind of a hilarious one, actually, because if you get hit by anything that causes knockback... Like, I was trying to purposely demonstrate with that soldier there, but I got hit by the beam. It causes a lot of knockback, so increased push force taken from like damage and air blasts, which is pretty hilarious. But at the same time, if you're wanting to kill someone, you want to stay closed in, right? So that's the downside. And other stuff, I have the Mad Milk. Mad Milk, much like with the Girardi, is like a nice team-based thing to help out with your team, you know, to get heals. Basically, get health on hit by a certain percentage, depending on the damage. Like, 60% of the damage that you do will get back to you as, like, healing, I believe. Yep. And the Holy Mackerel. Holy Mackerel is the same exact thing, stat-wise, as the bat, although it does this humiliation thing, where it shows up in the kill feed, even literally keeping track of the amount of hits that you do on an enemy. And that one's got a deck of cards swirling around his head. Or unusual. Nope. There's really not much that I can do to try to get into that spot. Although, what I can do is that probably I should go back to spawn somehow. If I can get the door to open. If someone's conveniently within spawn. Spawn at any time, please. Yeah, thank you. Anyway, let's go ahead and switch things up. Let's go back to default right now. But we're going to go ahead and try something really wonky with the use of a special can of energy drink. Here's Bonk Atomic Punch. All right. Hey, stop it. God damn! Man, what's with that guy? I don't know, but he has like a killstreak thing on his scattergun. He must mean serious business. Yeah, remember me? Yeah, you do. Well, anyway, like I was about to say, here's the Bonk Atomic Punch. This here will allow you to, basically, upon drinking it, it's basically the same effect as like if you were Ubered. However, you cannot attack while it's under effect. So basically, what this thing here is that it'll try to assist you to go through like choke points where normally a scout is unable to go. However, if the sentry's on the last point, then what's the point of bypassing it? Because what I'm trying to do with this is I want to activate it, and then somebody, like a power class, to come along with me. And, ooh, quick fix. There, good show. Excuse me. There was evil crit. He's out of reload. I'm able to catch him. There we go. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and sip this once, go right in, try to cause some weird carnage, or by that I mean distraction. And everyone and their goddamn grandmother hops in and say, "Party!" Jeez. But yeah, the whole thing of the punch is that it makes you bypass choke points like sentries. And most of the time, if players are very wary, they'll try to chase after you because, you know, you're being a distraction. Well, in that case, if you are being a distraction, I guess you're doing your job right because, you know, they're, like, focusing on you rather than the objective. Which, in this case, there's not much of an objective other than trying to, well, bypass our team first. Quite the standstill right now. Let's see. Alright, I'm just gonna not go in yet. What am I stuck on? What the shit? Honestly, what was I stuck on? Felt like I was like bumping into a spy, but like, horrible feeling. Well, maybe is there like a melee that I can mess about with? I guess Rap Assassin, I mean. I mean, like, I'm not going to be meleeing anytime soon, so I might as well take a look at this, like, weird one. So, Rap Assassin. You launch it the same way like you do with, like, the Sandman. You just launch an ornament. Woo! Here, let me take this. In fact, let me hug this. Let me at least prevent them from capping. Alright, they need to stay their asses on that point. Because it's very close to being capped. Anyway, Rap Assassin is just a projectile. Upon hitting it, it causes bleed damage. Nothing really significant about it. You'll have more utility out of the Sandman, most likely. So now over time, because they kind of capped us quite a bit. Oh, wait, what? Were they at the last point already? What? Wait. Holy shit! Oh, dude. Heavy, you deserve a high five for that. Okay, wrong Heavy. Holy shit, that was awesome.